1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
My name is Harry Kemp. I'm part of the Cobalts, a Stirling band, kind of 60s, 70s pop rock. My dad got me into guitar, so he gave me my first guitar, and he knew a couple chords. I played this weird Australian folk song. It's a horrible song, but it's got three chords in it, so I thought it was an easy way to start learning. I first started listening to Beatles, kind of everybody did at the start, classic Rolling Stone stuff, but that kind of stuck with me more than most people, I'd say. Israeli Gears and Lou Reed and stuff like that. They're kind of old, but they seem to have a good message in most of their songs. And they're kind of weird psychedelic as well. Yeah, writing's weird because nobody really teaches you how to write a song. You just kind of have to do it yourself. I hate doing theory. Some musicians read theory nonstop. I do most things by ear, which isn't the right way to do it, but it seems to work. Yeah, the start of the Cobalts kind of started off with me and Seamus busking just in Edinburgh and Glasgow. Sometimes making £20 and sometimes we made 200. Me and Seamus, we met in the Tolbooth here. And it was just a workshop for, it was a thing called Pump Up the Jam. It was just a workshop for musicians to get to know each other. And so I met Seamus and his brother here. And our drummer as well, he came to this. My first gig was here at the Tolbooth. It was a weird gig. We only played for 25 minutes. And I think we played two covers. But there's quite a lot of people there. The gigs that we really enjoyed are King Tut's. I played Albert Hall's in Stirling. That was cool. And the Castle on Hogmanay. That was our biggest gig. It was 2,000 people or whatever. But we got to play for half an hour as well. I didn't even know how we got that. It was crazy. A few of our gigs at the start were in Europa Music in Stirling. It's just a little record shop. And it's been there for a while, but it's got pretty good records in it, I recommend. We've played outside, I don't know, 3 or 4 times there on really cold winter's days for opening the lights in Stirling. Stirling's a weird one because there's not that many bands from Stirling. So the Stirling scene's pretty small, but we all know each other a lot because we play every third gig with each other. I feel bands now just kind of have to have a big social media presence. It's kind of a big thing of music is being able to sell your music and to share it and be marketable, pretty much. So just starting Facebook and Instagram accounts, kind of keeping everybody up to date when we're playing and what we're doing. Even if we're writing stuff or recording stuff, it's kind of good for people to know. Even if they don't really care at the start, but it all builds up. And with the band, I don't know, I just want to take it as far as I can. The more gigs we get and releasing music as well is also a big part when you get on Spotify and things. Because we have a few videos out, but nothing on Spotify.